Alright guys, so got the car in the garage after spending about an hour and a half trying to get it out of a ice hole and unfrozen. Now we're gonna clean up the engine bay, get rid of all these lines, and get it ready for the engine. Also, I want to kind of apologize for the sound quality. I still do not have an external mic. I still do not want to use my phone. The GoPro does look great, and you guys did say that the GoPro is fine. So just bear with me. The stuff for the external mic is on its way, so as soon as it gets here, all the rest of the videos will be better audio quality. So yeah, I just want to let you guys know that. So let's go ahead and go with this. Alright guys, this is all cleaned up, got the firewall and everything all cleaned, everything is all shiny again, so we are ready. So my fuel tank is here, this is where my fuel pump hanger and everything is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drill two holes in the side here, I'm going to run my lines to the pump, and then those two lines are going to come over here, they're going to go to top of the surge tank, and then a 10AN line is going to come out, and it's going to go to the external Bosch 044 pump. And from that pump, it's going to go from an AN10 to an AN8. It's going to go to the front. And then the return is going to come back. And it's going to go to an AN8 as well for the return to the surge. So what I'm going to do with the surge is, originally I thought about drilling holes and then bolting it down that way. But I think I'm just going to use self-tapping screws because, let's face it, I'm not going to be like yanking on the freaking surge tank. I mean, who's going to do that? No, nobody's going to do that, so that's what we're going to do today. I'm going to run this fuel system and get it all ready to go for when I put the engine back in. So, AN fitting. I need to cut a line for the AN10 out of my surge tank to the AN10 inlet on my fuel pump. The proper way to do this, and I'm going to tell you, I actually don't know the proper way, but I have a way that I have found out that works very well. It doesn't ever help try to put the line inside the fitting. That always sucks no matter what. What you want to do is tape the line up enough area to where, because you're going to cut right in the middle of the tape. And the tape is to keep the metal together so it doesn't fray on you, because you do not want it to fray. The next thing you're going to want is a grinder, and then you're just going to cut this thing in half. Okay, so what you're going to want to do is you're going to get it all the way on as far as you can get it, and you're going to have to twist it and push down on it all at the same time. And on the inside here, you can see the line getting to the top. You're going to want to push it all as far to the top as you possibly can, because that's how it will seal the best. Alright, so got an AN6 fitting right here. If you look on the inside, you can see these little grooves. These little grooves are, they're threaded, so whenever you put the line in there, it grips the line, so when you're twisting it, it kind of threads on like a nut. So you're going to want to make sure that you twist it whenever you put it on. You're going to take this end, and you're just going to, you have to push it as hard as you can until you can get to the thread. Once it threads, just make sure that the inlet here does not push the hose out, because that does happen sometimes. Another thing to note is to make sure that you get the fittings tightened down pretty much as tight as you can.
All right, guys, whipped out my phone again. My gimbal and the camera both died. But anyways, there it is. It's all set up and ready to run the lines and everything. I'm gonna be drilling some holes there for the lines going to the pump. And then I'm going to be drilling two holes there for the lines going to and from the engine. That's gonna do it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for coming and watching my parts and whatnot, for those of you that watched every single one. I appreciate it. I'm almost 600 subs at this time. I believe it's 10 or 9, something like that, till 600 subscribers, and I appreciate it so much. It gives me so much motivation to come outside and do things. Yeah, so off camera, I'm going to drill a couple holes and whatnot, try to see what I'm going to do with the lines. So that's what I'm going to do off camera. I'm not going to film it. That thing freaking died, both of them. So if it looks like there's some stuff done next video, that is why, but it's not going to be that much. So I'll see you guys in the next one. I drilled my holes and I basically ran a couple lines. I didn't run into the front. I'm going to have to drop the subframe today and the tank so I can tighten the fittings and run the lines the right way. And I got those fittings there and they run to the tank. And they're just going to come over here and they're going to feed those top lines there. Also, by the way, I did get my adapter for a mic and I do have a mic now. So I hope that this sounds fine. It's not the mic that I prefer, so I'm ordering a different one. But yeah, that's what I got. So hope this quality sounds fine.